2022 was a tough year. It was tough for many reasons. So we wanted to start 2023 with something good, something positive, something happy. And the best idea we could come up with is talking about happiness. Happiness. But the problem is that we, humanity, don't have a clear, operational, agreed upon definition of happiness. Many psychology labs around the globe are working on that. But happiness is not well defined yet. But we do know when we're happy. We know that some activities make us happier, some not so much. I reviewed a lot of papers on PubMed, watched hours of video from Andrew Huberman, Sam Harris, and other world experts on this topic. And in this video, I want to summarize what science knows about happiness and how to increase it. Science knows that 4 neurotransmitters out of 100 plus discovered until today can make us happier. So today we'll talk about these 4 chemicals, the so-called 4 happy hormones, how to leverage them to increase happiness, and I'll share my personal favorite ways to boost happiness. So you can apply those ideas yourself when you have time or when you feel down. So let's talk about that. Hi, Andrew here. Welcome to the Practical Health Channel. I'd like to start with one key fundamental idea. Happiness is heavily tied to survival. If something increases the chance of our survival, it makes us happier. Keep that in mind when we'll talk about these 4 happy hormones. Okay, what are these happy chemicals? On my list, I have dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, and endorphins. I said my list, since there are different ways of approaching this. Some people don't believe endorphins belong on the list. From my perspective, endorphins should be here, since there is a way endorphins can bring us euphoria. Some people add melatonin and adrenaline or epinephrine to this list. From my perspective, those hormones are critical for sleep and fight or flight response that don't directly lead to happiness, so I didn't add them to the list. Mine includes only these 4 chemicals. The first one is dopamine, probably the most famous of the happy hormones. After Andrew Huberman published his 2-hour video on dopamine in 2021, it feels like it's all anyone talks about. So let's start with dopamine. Dopamine is responsible for motivation, drive, pleasure, cravings. It helps us pursue things and is directly related to quality of our life. So if we want to go outside of our comfort zone and pursue things, dopamine becomes critical. So how we can increase dopamine? Dopamine goes up when we achieve something, when we're in the process of achieving something, and my favorite, when we're planning on achieving something. Why is it my favorite? Because achieving something requires effort. But to get from that lazy, apathetic state to an energetic, dopamine-heavy one, it takes 1 or 2 minutes to start planning. For example, say I decide to run a marathon. As soon as I get a piece of paper and a pen and start writing down my ideas on the registration process and my training plan, I get a dopamine increase and a lot of energy. So it really takes 1 or 2 minutes. Other ideas for increasing dopamine are to work out and to expose yourself to cold temperatures. Cold exposure is my another favorite. Every time I go to the sauna, you might know I'm a big fan of the sauna, I like to take a cold plunge to feel energized right away. So it's not only dopamine, but dopamine is a part of that mix of neurotransmitters. There are many other ways to increase dopamine through alcohol, porn, gaming, nicotine, chocolate, and many others. So the problem here is that those things will give us a quick spike and then a significant drop below the baseline. Since our channel is Practical Health, we focus on the healthy things. So think about increasing your dopamine level through healthy and sustainable means, through efforts with long-lasting effects, such as achieving something cool, something exciting, something fulfilling in your life, something that will change your life for better. Actually, understanding how you can get a dopamine spike is also very critical to boost energy, to boost mood, to boost happiness. But use those spikes responsibly. The next one is serotonin. Serotonin is all about pride, respect, status, and accomplishments. Every time someone gives you a compliment, especially someone whose opinion you value, you get an increase in serotonin. How we can increase serotonin besides getting compliments from other people? Low intensity exercise, sun time, and my another favorite, recalling happy moments. I found it's pretty amazing that when I go to bed at night and think about great things that I did during the day, I feel happy. So experiment yourself. When in bed at night, think about your accomplishment from earlier that day. Everyone has some. So you'll get an increase in serotonin. By the way, serotonin is precursor to melatonin, our sleep hormone. Serotonin is required for the production of melatonin. So by increasing serotonin at night, we increase melatonin and sleep better. Also, please don't miss any opportunity to increase serotonin. Don't dismiss compliments other people give it to you. If someone gives you a compliment, accept it and enjoy it. You'll get an increase in serotonin. Another common issue is that quite often we forget about our own accomplishments. So take some time to think about great things you did for the last week, for the last month, or the last year. The next one is endorphins, also known as painkillers. The word endorphin comes from two words, endogenous, meaning within the body, and morphine, opiate pain reliever. Endorphins help us kill pain and get to a safe place if we get trauma. For example, if an animal gets an injury, its endorphins rise and help that animal to get to a safe place. And this is exactly what's happening when we work out extensively or get a physical trauma. Physical, not mental. Okay, how we can increase endorphin levels besides working out extensively? Intense crying, intense laughing, and spicy food. Spicy food tricks the body into experiencing pain and leads to high endorphin levels. I definitely enjoy good humor and laughing, but spicy food is not for me. By the way, you might have heard about runner's high, where runners experience a state of euphoria after a long and intense run. A significant increase in endorphins level gets into the state of euphoria. Actually, it helped me understand why I enjoy my long runs and soccer games so much. I definitely get that sense of euphoria. The last happy hormone, usually the most overlooked, is oxytocin. It's love or networking hormone. If you look at the situation through the survival lens, social bonding or being a part of a group increases the chance of our survival. In case of a sheep, being a part of a herd increases the chance of its survival. So, social bonding, trust, empathy increase the chance of our survival and increase our happiness. So, how we can increase oxytocin? By hugging, by touching, and being in the proximity to other people. Another way to increase oxytocin is to have strong connection with family members, friends, and good people in general. Also, I'd like to highlight that social media is not a real social environment. Though we do have connections there, social media is a fake social environment that leads to overstimulation of oxytocin production and negative consequences. So try to focus on something real, connecting with family members, friends, good people, and leveraging the power of hugging, touching, and good conversations. By the way, if you've been to big sporting events in stadiums or big concerts, I'm sure you remember that cool feeling of being a part of the crowd. That was oxytocin. So, this is the list of so-called four happy hormones: dopamine, serotonin, oxytocin, and endorphins. So, and I tried to list various activities that can help us increase each of them, and I underline my favorite ones in green. By the way, a poor diet, lack of sleep, disrupted circadian rhythm, and so on can damage production of each of those neurotransmitters. So, a healthy lifestyle is critical. Also, I'd like to give you some ideas for boosting multiple happy hormones at the same time. For example, if you have an intense run and set your personal record time, you'll get both endorphins and dopamine. Or, for example, when you have a morning run with your friends, low intensity run with your friends, you'll get both serotonin and oxytocin. Finally, I'd like to share a couple things that make me really happy, and I found a simple explanation why. The little increase of all four happy hormones. So, the first one is my soccer game in our local league on Sunday morning. So, as you might know, I love soccer. I've been playing soccer for more than 40 years. Usually those games are physically intense, so I get endorphins. When I win, and usually I win, it's an achievement, so I'm getting a dopamine increase. When I get compliments from other people for my play, and usually I play well, I get serotonin. And finally, soccer is a team play. So I'm playing with my friends, so I'm getting oxytocin. So no surprises, I really like those games. The other activity that I really enjoy is visiting the sauna at Archimedes Bunny in San Francisco. Usually my experience in the sauna is quite intense. We're trying to get to the hottest possible level. So endorphins go up. Usually it's quite an achievement and we are proud of ourselves. So dopamine and serotonin go up. And finally, usually I go to sauna with my friends and we have good time. So oxytocin level goes up too. These two activities help me increase all four happy hormones and feel incredibly rewarding. So no surprise, I really like them. So, and I believe that's it for today. I hope this video gave you a good overview of four neurotransmitters that are responsible for our happiness. Take a look at your favorite daily activities through the lens of these four happy hormones and try to understand why you love those activities, why they make you happy. It will give you a lot of ideas for things to do when you feel down or feel depressed. By the way, if you have a family member or a friend who feels down or depressed, please send them this video. I hope we'll help them to get to a happier state. And as usual, if you like this video, give us a like. If you don't like it, subscribe to our channel. One day we'll create a video that you love. Your favorite video of all time. Stay strong, stay healthy, be happy, and see you next time. Bye.